Today I have a lecture to you, to the member of Greater Mekong sub-region that include six countries that I know. So that is including with Cambodia, China, Lao People's Democratic Republic, Myanmar, Vietnam, and Thailand is the last one. Today is my lecture, maybe, because I'm only 2 months before retirement. So that now I'm only 2 months. So that I think that this is my last English lecture in Thailand. So that is my honor, really honor, to give a lecture to you. My topic is volunteer soil doctors and their participation in soil resource management in Thailand. This is very important. That the objectives of this one, because the farmer in Thailand have many problems about the soil fertility and problem soils, that we have to solve to help them. This is our objectives, so that we want to achieve less chemical used in agriculture for conservation of soil resource and environment, and so that we put an attention into the soil water conservation and soil organic matter, because of the nowadays the price of the fertilizer, chemical fertilizer, is increasing, so that and the world need to go to the green market, so that to solve the problem of the high budget of the fertilizer, so that we try to put the soil organic matter substitute for the chemical fertilizer, and to use the products of LDD, or Land Development Department, and appropriate technology for promotion and extension by volunteer soil doctor to the farmers. Now the problem is, what is the volunteer soil doctor? That's the so that in Thailand, we have the total area is about 51.4 million hectares. We have the problem of erosion area is about 21.4 million hectares, and deteriorate soil 15.8 million hectares. This is a right large number. It's mostly is up in the up northern part of Thailand, and this one go around the country, the whole country. So that how to solve the problems? This is our strategy. So that we're looking that and analysis that. What is the problem and how to solve the problem of the soil fertility and soil physical property? So that we think, and then Thailand, nearly 50% is growing rice, and we have the problem is too much supply, and now our friend Vietnam have a lot of rice to export, and now become as the winner before Thailand nowadays, and Myanmar is coming up, chasing with our back. So that is the problem. How to decrease the budget to solve the problem of the price of the rice? Because the former government tried to increase the price of the rice, that the problem to the country nowadays, comparing with the Vietnamese rice price. Thai rice is about 550 US dollar per ton, but Vietnamese rice is 450 only. So that we have the problem. So that we try to solve the problem. The problem solving is appropriate soil management. We have to control erosion, improve soil organic matter. This is very important to decrease the chemical fertilizer and minimize chemical use, because it's the price of the is control the price is chemical fertilizer and chemical pesticide. That's the problem to decrease. So that Land Development Department got responsibility for conservation of soil resource environment, because erosion decrease the soil fertility of the soil. So that we have to conduct research and development, we have to do soil and water conservation and increase soil organic matter that I will tell you later on how to increase the soil organic matter in the soil. The problem is that nowadays we have not enough government of service. Nowadays the population of Thailand is about 65 million. But the population of the government service is very low comparing with the number of the population, 65 million. How? But if we increase the government service, we have to increase a lot of salary. So that we try to put the volunteer, no salary to this one to solve our problem. We have to prepare volunteer to help the farmer. This is our strategy. So that volunteer soil doctor, they are the farmers in the village and try to help land development department to solve the soil problems. Transferring new technology and land development department products to their neighbors and participating in land development department activities. And thirdly, to conduct the demonstration plot of vegetable grass for soil and water conservation and soil organic matter improvement. This is a very important strategy from our king to decrease the erosion. This is the purpose. So that nowadays we have the website of the volunteer soil doctor. This is our website from the department and from the government as well, so that the people can go to see the information and the history and many informations from the volunteer soil doctor into the website of the land development department and to the government as well. And this is the in concentration of the basic data. The example of the volunteer soil doctor in Thailand is includes with 77 province, 927 district, and 7,409 sub-district, and 74,944 village. So that this is the number of the soil volunteer soil doctor the whole country, so that we get free of charge officer if we train them in the well managed. So that the total of the whole country, we have 74,944 volunteer soil doctor. You may surprising why I don't add 77 with 927. If we add up, it been bigger. But from the budget, so that we cannot separate province from the district and sub-district, so that the one who is the volunteer soil doctor in class of the province will be the district as well in their hometown. So that the number is, this is the same province, is the same, the district of their hometown. Is the same volunteer soil doctor in the level of sub-district in their hometown. And then to the village, this one will be the volunteer soil doctor in the level of village as well, so that it not added up, okay? So that the whole country, the village, the whole country is 74,944, so that the whole country is about 74,944 volunteer soil doctor. Don't add up, okay, because of the budget of the country. And then this is the distribution of the volunteer soil doctor the whole country in the province, so that I just passed is what they are trained. This is the important. We have 74,000 about what they are trained. So that we the training program, that's the intensive training of the volunteer soil doctor. We teach them learning by doing, and we make a network building, and then we give them the materials distribution of the land development department the materials so that in 2004 it's total is about 60,000. Nowadays we increase the number of the volunteer soil doctor. This is the intensive training. We teach them a lot of subjects. Two training costs annually so that volunteer soil doctor, they will be trained two times a year. And this is the practicing of the planting of the vegetable grass. This is for soil erosion around the bund of the farm pond and at the road, around the road. This one, we teach them to the school to make a contour, a small contour by vegetable grass, by plant vegetable grass by conservation. So that what is they are trained in the soil science, there are factors controlling crop yield. Firstly is the positive factors that we teach them that they have to know about the optimal environment. We teach them temperature, light, water, and altitude. Because of that, the many kinds of plants are differ in temperature, light, water, and altitude they need for the optimum growth. This is the important. So that before the people intend to grow plant, they have to do the data about the temperature, light, water, and altitude at their place. So that the next one, we have to teach them the good variety of plant to select. Because it's very important, good variety is mean that they can get better yield. And then the third one, third factor is the good soils. And we have to teach them what is the productive soils. And the second factor is about the negative factors, that the pest, we have to go away from the pest. The pest is, this one is the insect, disease, and weed. From the good variety, they can survive from the insect and disease, and they cannot go away from the weed. So that this is the optimal factor controlling the growth of the plant. That because this one is the environment, that the temperature, light, water, but this one is the essential element, that is nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, calcium. This one, if this one is our optimum situation or is the same height of the wood to make this jug. If this one, for example, in the soil, the lack of nitrogen, so that this one is the limiting factor to control the yield of the plant. So that the farmer have to know that the soil, what is the limiting factor in the soil, so that they have to analyze the soil. They have to know the data of the soil. So that's when we teach them what is the good soil or productive soil. For example, is this one is the very good soil, is it? You think this one is good one? No? Oh, these are people from this kind of land. Okay? Hey, this is what is it? Very good cloth, huh? Louis Vuitton. Do you know Louis Vuitton? Brand name out of France. The very expensive bag, something like that, huh? The people in this kind of land, they're really poor. So that productive soil is mean that good physical properties, good chemical properties. Chemical properties is include with two factors, that optimal pH and sufficient essential elements. This means if fertilizer a chemical fertilizer or organic fertilizer, that's no matter. It needs only the amount of the essential element. And the third one is the good microbial activities. So that this is really important factor to control the yield of the plant. I already told you that this one is good soil and productive soil, okay? And this one, if they have already three factors, physical property, chemical property, and microbial activity, but they have the pest, it cannot go to the good productive yield. So that this is very important that if the soil, if they have 5% of organic matter, it means that very good soil. If the soil have 5% of organic matter, it means that no need to put any chemical fertilizer. If they have 5% of organic matter, it means that it's a good physical property. It has a good microbial activity as well. So that we need to put the soil, organic matter of the soil, to 5% or more. But nowadays in Thailand, the organic matter content on the whole country is less than 1%. Less than 1%. So that we have to put a lot of organic matter into the soil. Not in the soil in Thailand. It's the same situation in China, in Vietnam, Myanmar, Laos, Cambodia, and Thai. The whole strategy is to increase the yield. You have to increase the amount of organic matter into the soil. This is the important one. This is, for example, two kinds of texture. This one is a heavy soil. This one is a loose one. This one or this one is better. Mr. Billy, which one is better between this one is a heavy soil, this one is a very loose soil. Which one is better to grow plant? Which one is better? Yellow one, left hand. We agree? Left hand soil is better than right hand soil. Are you agree? No. Why? Who think that right hand is better? Oh. So that who choose left hand? Raise up your hand. No one. Right hand. Raise up your hand up. Only one, the less what? Okay. If we grow rice, left hand is better. Heavy soil, they can collect a lot of water into the field, right? But in this one, if you grow, for example, cassava, corn, it's not good because it's a heavy soil. Okay. So that this one, if you grow rice, it cannot collect the water into the field. So that water go away. So that the texture is depend on kind of plant you growing. Okay? So that is the important one. This one is not bad if you grow rice or make a pond. Okay? This one is good if you grow upland crops. But it's not good for rice. And then this is the picture of the good soil. So that 16 essential elements for plant growth, carbon, hydrogen, oxygen from air and water. This one free of charge. So that nowadays we need to put nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium. This one stayed in chemical fertilizer and stay in organic fertilizer as well. And we need calcium, magnesium, and sulfur. This one, we need a large amount. But we still need iron, manganese, zinc, copper, boron, molybdenum, and chlorine. this one we the plant need in a small, very very small amount, but cannot neglect it. So that if you put organic matter, you put the whole elements into the soil, but it's not enough in nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium. If you have to substitute chemical fertilizer by organic matter, you have to substitute with 3 tons of organic matter, or 18 tons per hectare to substitute chemical fertilizer. Okay? Again, if you put organic fertilizer, you will get all the elements from the organic matter. But it's not enough if you put less than 6 tons per hectare. If you want to substitute chemical fertilizer. So that when you put organic matter or organic fertilizer, normally it's not enough nitrogen and phosphorus and potassium. So that the more concentrate, it can come from manure. This one in the red color come from liquid fertilizer. So that I'm not sure that this morning Dr. Noy taught you about, not yet, okay, tomorrow, right? They will teach about the microbial activity to make the liquid fertilizer tomorrow. Okay, nitrogen. Nitrogen is had effective for growth from the vegetative growth, nitrogen from vegetative growth. Phosphorus for build up flower and yield. If the land lack of phosphorus cannot produce flower, it means no yield or not enough yield. And then this is the phosphorus. You know this one? Yeah, very tasty for me, but not for you maybe. And then potassium. Potassium is good for the root plant. So that nitrogen. This one, nitrogen for vegetative growth. Phosphorus for flowering and yield. And then the third one, potassium for the root crop. This is the factor. So that you nowadays, if we teach the volunteer soil doctor, so that they will know the activities of the elements in this one. So that for the one who grow vegetable, they have to concentrate on nitrogen fertilizer. Okay? This means that the farmer have to put nitrogen higher than phosphorus and higher than potassium, because this is the effect of the nitrogen. When they need the flower and yield, at a good time, like people, for that, when they are young, and when they grow to the mature, when they need to have the children, this time, they need phosphorus, for example. And then potassium, when you grow carrot, something like that, but it means that this kind of plants stay under the soil. So that this kind of plant need potassium higher than nitrogen and phosphorus. This is the effect of the elements. And then the farmers and volunteer soil doctor have to know that the optimum pH of the soil should be stay around 5.5 to 7.5 or 8. And pH of the water should stay between 6.5 and 8 as well. So that when we teach them that if we investigate the soil or analyze the soil, and if the soil stay in the range of pH between 5.5 and 7.5, we need not to prepare the soil by putting alarm. Okay, this one. And water is very important when you grow such kind of animal. For example, shrimp, they need the pH of the water between this one. So that we have to fix the leakage. For example, from the soil analysis, from this one, this environment, boron is the limiting factor. So that when we know this one, we have to put the boron into the soil so that this one will not be the limiting factor anymore. So that when we increase to this level, next one may be sulfur. We have the problem. Next one, if we solve the problem of sulfur, then potassium may be the problem. We have to solve the problem. But by adding essential components, we have to think about the economical use. This one, this is an example of the plant that lack of the iron and manganese deficiency on the citrus. This one have showed the symptom of this one, for example. This one, when you grow tomato, this one is is get the problem of calcium deficiency. This one will occur in the chemical soil or acid soil will have this problem because in the acid soil they lack of calcium. This one, so that they have the problem of calcium deficiency. We know that 1 ton of compost has only 18 to 30 kilogram of available nitrogen per hectare. 1 ton is of the compost in have about 18 to 30 kilogram of available nitrogen per hectare. So that this one we have the data that to grow rice 1 ton, what is the amount of nitrogen they need to take from the soil? So that this one is the amount of the 1 ton of the compost. So that when you need to put the fertilizer in the form of the compost, you have to know that it has only 18 to 30 kilogram of available nitrogen per hectare only. And extract liquid fertilizer has a very small amount of available nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium, so that it is impossible to put a liquid fertilizer to substitute chemical fertilizer. Okay, when you put the liquid fertilizer, it means that you have to put the micro element into the soil. That if you go back, that I show in the red element. Okay, you remember in the red element. Okay, this one, liquid fertilizer. This one. For example, this one, that soil lack of molybdenum. So that you can put liquid fertilizer instead of the chemical fertilizer in this one. For sustainable agriculture, so that you have to put plant nutrients back to the soil equal to nutrients lost from the land as crops harvested. This one is very important. What does it mean? When you sell the rice from the field, for example, 6 tons per hectare, it means that rice take away the fertility from your soil. Okay? When you sell the rice plant from the paddy field, 6 tons per hectare, it means that the soil takes a lot of fertilizer from the soil. If every year you did not put any fertilizer return back into the soil will become less fertility. It means lack of essential element. This is the picture after when the volunteer soil doctor come, we teach them the importance of essential element And this one we teach them to know about the map, soil map. The kind of soil, this one is acid sulfate soil. Some part of China go along the coastal area or stay close to the sea. This one, acid sulfate soil, has a large area in Vietnam, in some part of Myanmar, in Cambodia somewhere, close to the Trat province, somewhere. This one, this is, in this one, this yellowish color of the soil, the pH of this area is about 2.8. Normal plant grow, pH of the normal soil, good pH stay between 5.5 to 8, but this color, the pH is about 2.8. You can imagine how the crop can grow in this area. This one really loose, so that we have land development material. This one is microbial activity that some lecturer will come to give a lecture to you tomorrow about this one. But this one is the microbial activity for making a compost. All these things we give to the farmer free of charge. This one free of charge. This one we call it LDD number 1, LDD number 2, LDD number 3, LDD number 4, LDD number 5, LDD number 6, LDD number 7. From now is LDD 12. The whole thing, whole stuffs, the government give to the farmer free of charge. This is the duty of the volunteer soil doctor to distribute this one to their friend in the village, because of we not have enough staff. So that volunteer soil doctor will be the one who distribute on the staff to the farmer. This one to make a compost, this one to make a liquid fertilizer. This one is controlling the pest, disease. This one is fungi. This one nowadays no more produce. This one, nowadays is no more. Number 6 is when this will prepare material to prepare. This one is the waste from the household. For example, you have rice, eat the rice and you not eat it all, some still left, so that you can make the rice foodstuff to make a liquid fertilizer by this one. And this one, if you use an organic paste to control the pesticide, this one is the objective. Tomorrow there will be another lecturer come to teach you this one. So that if we have two factors, good factor in the environment, light, temperature, altitude, good soil, good microbial activity, good soil, you will get wheat, good production, good yield. It's our strategy. So that in the field, we have the analyzed service, mobile service. This one, every month, the government and all by the land development department will go into the village and go to analyze the soil from the farmers free of charge, free of charge. And then this one, the volunteer soil doctor will come to help to bring the soil samples come to be analyzed from this one as well. And the volunteer soil doctor can analyze the soil as well, but different method. They can have this one analyzed in the laboratory. In this one, volunteer soil doctor, they have the test kit to analyze the soil free of charge as well. So that this one, when analyzed data come, they will give the data about pH, EC to tell that the soil are saline or not. The pH, what is the pH in the soil, the number of organic matter into the soil, number, the amount of the phosphorus into the soil and amount of potassium into the soil. This one is from the analyzed data. And then we have the mobile to extension to the farmer about how to solve the problem of the soil in your hometown or land. We have the map of the problem soil along the country or the whole country. And then if the farmers don't know the analysis of the soil in their land, do they need to sell, to send the soil sample to be analyzed or not? Nowadays, Land Development Department had a computer program to check that the soil, every sub-district, what is the fertility of the soil. This is the example of the computer program to solve the problem. So that the farmer need not to send the soil sample into the laboratory, so that they can know the fertility of their land. But this one is good in 50% only. If you send the soil data, soil sample, to the laboratory, you will know the data 100%. Okay, correct. So that, for example, in this one, if you collect the soil sample and then send it to the laboratory, the laboratory will analyze that soil and will tell the pH, EC, or salinity, the organic matter content, phosphorus, and potassium. This is mean correct 100%. But this one use a computer program, is been correct or true 50%. Because of the map, okay, but it's better than nothing, right? So that by computer program is just use a double click here. Then it come along with the map of the district, the whole of the. This one is the map of Nakhon Ratchasima province in my controlling. This one is include with 32. District, 32 districts, so that the farmer or volunteer soil doctor come with this program can select which is the hometown of the farmer or their land. And then when they choose the district, it come along with the sub-district map, so that you can choose which one. Or for example, at this one, known soon sub-district. So that you choose this one, known soon sub-district. Oop, it comes with the map. It's a soil map. This one, the whole country, we use the soil groups. The whole country has about 62 soil groups. The whole country has 62 soil groups. And then group number 25 is a lowland or the farmer field. So that this one, you know, number 7 is a paddy field. Number 20, in Thailand, number 1 to 25 is a lowland or paddy field. Number 26 to 62 is a highland. Okay? So that this one, 20 is mean that this area is suitable for the paddy or rice. This one, 40, is not suitable for to grow rice, okay? And W is mean water. And then for them, if the farmer want to know that soil number 7, you just put the cursor into the 7. This means that the data of the soil data number 6. In this one, they will tell you that's the texture elevation is this is the cross section of the soil profile that you went to the soil museum. Okay, you went to the soil museum downstairs, right, before coming to this one. And this one will tell you what's of the picture of the soil data. And then from this one, we have the data. This one, the data of pH. This is the data of organic matter. This is the data of phosphorus. This is the data of available potassium. It's surprising why different color. Why it's so different color. I put this one is a green mean good or optimum. Red is not good or low level. So that from this one, organic matter is stay in the medium station. And this one, the red color is mean in this low. So that this one, in this one, do you need to solve the problem with the lime or not? No, because the pH color is in green. So that the volunteer soil doctor need not to analyze, they just know the color. Oh, this soil, we have to concentrate in organic matter because it stay in the medium situation. Oh, phosphorus, very low. Potassium, very low. So that if you grow the plants in this one, maybe no yield because phosphorus is very low. You have to put a lot of phosphorus fertilizer. You have to put a lot of potassium fertilizer in this one. So that is the way to decrease the chemical fertilizer or use the correct compost, right? This is this one is about 0 to 20 centimeter level of the soil. And the second one is about the 20 to 40 centimeter of the soil below the soil. Okay. This enlarging. Come with this one, pH of the soil. I told you that the optimum pH should stay between 5.5 to 8 or 5.5 to 7.5. This one, the pH of the upper soil is about 5.5 to 6.5. It stay in a good condition. No need to correct anything. But the second one, organic matter content in this soil is stay in the medium level. We have to put some organic matter, still need to put some organic matter. But this one we have to concentrate on phosphorus and potassium one. So that the whole country, we have the data, this data. And give this data to the farmer or volunteer soil doctor. This one, do they need to use a computer? The problem. Do they need to use a computer? No. You just print this one to give to the volunteer soil doctor, print into the paper and put on the wall so that they know they need not to use any computer, right? Come back to the program. If we need to have the data, we have to use the computer, this one. But when we click to this one, go to this one, go to this one, go to this one, and then when we train the farm with volunteer soil doctor, we print this one to the volunteer soil doctor so that every sub-district or every village will have this map along their place or their hometown. So that when they have this map, they need not to use any computer, right? And then in this one, they have the data about the amount of the fertilizer. This program, there are six kinds of plant. We have the data of fertilizer data for the rice or paddy. We have for the corn, we have for the cassava. We have the data for the sugar cane. We have the oil palm and para rubber. There are six fertilizer data for recommendation according to the soils. For example, this soil is number six. We have the data that for the photosensitive rice. Photosensitive rice. The farmer need to put 36 kilogram of nitrogen fertilizer, available fertilizer, into the paddy soil. This one, this kind of soil, they need to put 36 kilogram available phosphorus in 1 to 1 hectare of the field, and they have to put 36 kilogram of available potassium per 1 hectare to the field. They will get the best yield of the rice. This is a recommendation. So that this one need not computer as well. Just print this one, give to the volunteer soil doctor. This one, if they carry on the back, they know this is a map of their district or village. So just use carry on the back. The recommendation is already, so that they just know which is the part of the neighborhood or which part of the land with this one. For example, we have the benchmark on the map, so that we know that this is the school from this one. From this one to this line, it means that 1 kilometer apart. From this line to this line, 1 kilometer apart. This one is about 665 multiplied by 6 per hectare. This one is the end area on the soil map. Well, this is example of the, this one no recommendation for the corn, because of this one in the rainy season is flooding, so that is not suitable for corn. And this one for cassava, not suitable, so that no data. Sugarcane, no data. Palm, oil palm, no data. Because this soil group is not suitable to such kind of plants. Para rubber, no data as well. So that at the house of the volunteer soil doctor, we will prepare the data of this one is the LDD number 2, how to make it, how to teach to the farmer at the neighborhood around their house. And then when we have the extension service, we go to the farmer field. We give free of charge. This is green manure. This free of charge as well. We use this kind of plant. You see, this is an example of the green manure and LDD stuff. And then in some part, we will bring some screen, have the projector to teach them as well in the field. And then this, we teach them how to prepare to make a liquid fertilizer by LDD number 2. And then after that, you will see which one, this guy. This one is 12 years ago. 12 years ago. This is my picture 12 years ago. But nowadays, going only 2 months to retire for my retirement. Now I am 59 and 10 months old. Only 2 months before retirement. So that I told you this is my last English lecture, maybe. Okay, the problems. So that we have the limit number of soil testing laboratory. Nowadays, we solve the problem with a computer program. Okay? It's a lengthy delay in receiving soil test result. Oh, yes. It needs about not less than 1 month when the farmer send the soil sample to the laboratory. At least 1 month, the farmer will get the result. Very long time, isn't it? Very long time. So that when you use the computer program, just only 10 minutes. Just only 10 minutes. But the it's only 50% correct. And only blanket fertilizer recommendation are available. It means that it's not correct one, just only blanket fertilizer recommendation. So that this objective, so that we develop a site-specific NPK fertilizer recommendation. And then the secondly, we increase the farmer's capability to manage nutrients and then production problem. So that this is I return back. This is very important so that I want to concentrate. This one very important. Every place not the same fertilizer recommendation. It depends on kind of soil. Every soil different in data, this data. So that the farmer will get different recommendation depend on kind of the soil on the map. Okay? This is the correction one. Okay, this is a test kit that the volunteer soil doctor equipment or tools to show the farmers. So that when we, the most important is the how to collect the soil sample. This is the very important. So that this one step in our site-specific nutrient management for small farms. Then we have to make a soil series identification from this one. We have to make an NPK testing in the field. This one, the first step, we have to make the soil series identification by putting or see the detail on the map. What kind of the soil or soil series? And then taking the soil sample, testing with the soil test, and then outcoming with the data from the analysis. The volunteer soil doctor should have the ability to make the fertilizer recommendation as well. This is our aim. Simplify so that soil series identification that we have to check the soil color, soil texture, soil pH, or coarse fragment or soil depth. This is the data of the soil series. And then testing. This one we have, this one can measure the pH, organic matter content, phosphorus content, and potassium content by test kit. This one is about, nowadays, about 4,000 baht. This one can analyze the soil sample about 50 samples. About 4,000 baht can analyze the soil about 50 samples. And by using the important thing, you have to get the good soil sample. This is the most important, and then analyzed by volunteer soil doctor. This one check the pH and phosphorus, and using the addition aids. Then sometimes the. I think maybe not the whole country. We have the computer, small computer like this. It's the data. Check in the field. Check the color of the soil. Testing. And then put a fertilizer recommendation. So that's the products of agriculture to support food safety policy. We have to make a good soil management for what? High level of output. If we need high level of output, we have to make a soil analysis and analyze the pH, the salinity, organic matter content, phosphorus and potassium, which one is lacking. And then we put the correct fertilizer into the soil. And we have to think about the cost effectiveness as well, that do we need chemical fertilizer or we have to substitute then with the organic fertilizer. Nowadays, because of the price of the rice in Thailand is very, very low now. One ton of the soy in Thailand now become about 6,000 to 7,000 baht only nowadays. Last 6 months, the price of the rice is about 15,000 baht. Last 6 months ago, but after revolution or something like that, the price of the rice go down to 6,000 to 7,000 only. Now we can export to Vietnamese rice. Nowadays, Thai rice will go down to $400 per ton, but last year $550 per ton, but today only $4,000 per ton. So that we have to competitive with the Vietnamese. But how about the farmer? Low income, can survive or not? That's the problem. We have to teach them how to decrease the cost of the production, and then conserve environment, sustainable agriculture. Then invented by Land Development Department scientists for promotion and extension to farmers by volunteer soil doctor. From now you know that what is the subject that the volunteer soil doctor are trained at. They know how to select the microbiome data, computer data map. They know what kind of the soil group into the land. They know the pH, organic matter content, phosphorus, potassium into the soil of their land and to the neighbor. No need to analyze. If they need to analyze, they just put the test kit and then have the right recommendation to the fertilizer recommendation, so that no more waste the fertilizer or incorrect using the chemical fertilizer, this one, so that this is the way to decrease the cost of the growing rice, any kind, six kinds of plants that I already told you, rice, corn, cassava, sugarcane, oil palm, para rubber, so that we have the data by experiment and anything. This is the way. So that the next thing, that the green manure. This is the free of charge of nitrogen fertilizer taking from the air by using the leguminous crops or green manure for what? For increasing soil organic matter. I already told you that nowadays Thai soil has the organic matter content less than 1%. But the ideal soil, it should have about 5% organic matter. So that nowadays is less than 1%. Comparing with the Vietnamese soil have the Mae Khong Delta. The fertilizer come from Tibet, China. The fertility come along with the Mae Khong River and then put into the basin of Vietnam. So that Vietnamese soil, nearly no need to put fertilizer because it take away from greater Mae Khong sub-region, China. Fertilizer come down to what? To Cambodia, to some part of Vietnam, before going down to the sea. So that a lot of fertilizer come. That's it, the low investment to grow rice. But it's a pity, some part of the Vietnamese land is the acid sulfate soil. If they put the lime into the land, increase the pH to 5.5 to 7, is really ideal soil, right? But it's a pity, Thai soil, organic matter content lower than 1, cannot fight together, right? so that we have to increase our organic matter by broadcasting the seed sprouted during the blooming, complete decomposition, improve soil structure. It's a physical property that I already told you. Improve soil organic matter plus nutrients. What kind of nutrient? It depends on soil analysis from computer program, from what kind of the soil group, right? So that we know what is the amount of fertilizer, what kind of fertilizer we put into the plant. This is the nutrient I mean. And then this is a green manure. This one, this kind of plant is a leguminous plant. It has some rhizobium into their root. And this one will take the nitrogen in the air and storage into the plant. And this one, this last one is a Sesbania lostrata. Improved soil organic matter in the plant if rice. And then the dry matter is about 500 kilograms per rice, or about 3 tons per hectare. This one, just put about 50 kilograms of the seed for 1 hectare. Just put this seed about 50 kilograms per hectare. It will get 3 tons per hectare organic matter. So that we need not to buy the compost. We just put this one and plow it. Nitrogen is about 2.5 to 3% per rye. And you can multiply this data by 6. Go to 1 hectare, multiply by this data by 6.25. It become percent per hectare. And then phosphorus is about 0.3 to 0.4, and then potassium is about 2 to 2.78%. This one, if you want to need the data per hectare, I already put the data is about multiply this one by 6.25, it become per hectare. This one very beautiful flower. At this stage, it has the highest nitrogen content in their plant. This one, dry matter, about half ton per right, or 6 tons per hectare. Three tons per hectare. Crotalaria junxia, this one. Green manure, and then after this one, plowing, incorporate green manure into the plant. After this one, after 1 week, you can grow plant after this one. In this one, no need to put nitrogen fertilizer because it's a free of charge, taking away from the air already. This is a green manure crop, plowing for soil organic matter. From this one, do you still need to put nitrogen fertilizer? No need, no need, okay? Free of charge. It's very cheap, this seed. But they need to work hard. The farmer need to work hard, not lazy. Okay, beautiful flower. Flowering. And then vetiver grass for soil and water conservation to reduce soil erosion, increase soil moisture, and improve soil organic matter. This one, our king, the initiation of the vetiver grass for soil conservation. I already told you that Vietnamese land, Vietnamese soil is ideal because of the fertilizer come from Tibet, from China, from Myanmar, going settling down into Vietnam before going down to the sea. But because of the erosion of the land, so that our king thinking of this one, so that recommend vetiver grass to protect the soil erosion, so that to reduce the fertilizer decreasing of the soil. There's an upland up north in Chiang Mai province. So that is why we have the conservation. This is a strawberry one, this strawberry. It's beautiful, isn't it? And then I told you that we train them 2 times a year. And at the first stage, we teach them about the technical. And the second stage, we brought them or carried them to the field to have the experience into the field in such a different way. Thank you. No time to drink. Okay. Okay, this one, they teach them how to make the contour by using the easy equipment. And then this is the stock of the vegetable grass. Sometimes we gave the chance to the volunteer soil doctor to prepare this one and sell vegetable grass to our department as well. This is how to produce the vegetable grass. This one, free of charge to the farmer, free of charge. Okay, preparing the seed, bare root, and then producing the stock of the vegetable grass, 50 by 50 centimeter. Oh, is it good? Lost the soil, lost the land. This load maybe if you go away this one, if you lucky you can go down. Okay, go to the hill, maybe really enjoyable. And then this one, you have to protect them with the vegetable grass. Okay, a lot of erosion, this real one. This one, landslide is the problem. So that vegetable grass will protect the landslide. Okay, this is a water harvest. From this one, it's a curve down to the slope. So that this one will collect the water to make the water run slowly. So when the water go down slowly, it means can go into the deeper soil. This is the situation, and then this is a procedure to collect the water. This is the orchard. This is the orchard. My presentation, you can get my PowerPoint, no need to take the picture, right? Okay, free. This PowerPoint presentation free of charge to you, bring back to your country, okay? And then vegetable grass is about 800 to 1,000 meters up to the mean sea level. This one to make a contour. We don't need the mechanical one. They just use the vegetable grass to make a contour, this one. So that decreasing the soil erosion. In the upland, this is the people in the upland, Hin tribe. Okay, this one from the vegetable grass can make the protection soil mulching. This one is a mulching. Okay, so that a vegetable grass after cutting make and mulching so that it can control the moisture content of the soil. Then come out with a very good strawberry, very good price. Okay. And this is, what is it, you know, what's the purpose of this one? Making a roof, okay. And then this mulching, okay. It's a farm pond. Thai government, this one, putting this farm pond into the farmers. This costs about 20,000 baht per pond, this one. It's been, this one is about 1,260 cubic meter of the soil digging up. This one, the cost one pond is about 20,000 baht. And this one, free of charge to the farmer. The farmer have to pay 2,500 baht for the government, and then the cost of this pond, 20,000 baht, the farmer has to pay 2,500 baht. The rest is up to the government, free of charge. Okay. We put this one nearly the whole country. Last year, we give them 80,000 pounds. Last year, 80,000 pounds, the whole country. Free of charge. The farmer have to pay 2,500 baht. It means that we collect the water into this pond year by year. We need not to put the dam. Cannot make a dam, big dam. But this one is small dam, collecting the water into the field, right? Then the hill tribe, we teach them how to grow vegetable grass. The school boy, school girl, teach them to grow vegetable grass by volunteer soil doctor and our service officer. Okay, this one, steep slope, have to prepare this one. Maybe accident go down, boop, go to the heaven. Okay. Hedge rows distance 10 meters, so that we have the test under the soil, and then we have the data to put this one, hedge row. So that this one, the purpose is to slow down runoff, reduce soil erosion, collect soil moisture, and increase infiltration. Yes. So that is an ideal. Or up north, contour bank. This one the same purpose. Slow down runoff, reduce soil organic, soil erosion, correct soil moisture, increase infiltration. The same one. Bench terrace. Slope higher than 35%, we need to make a bench terrace. Okay, this advantage of vegetable grass around the pond, small canal, gallery protection. And then I come back to charge message. What time left? 15 minutes. Okay, go. Okay, LDD number one for make the. In this one, we have the effective microbes to decompose crop residue for making a compost. So that, I'm not sure that I gave you the sample of LDD number one back home or not. It should have. Nah, you should have this sample back home. Okay, then you increase the population of microbial. And then, but it's not sure, when going to China, Thai microbial stay in the temperature is about 30 to 35. Going up north to China, very, very cold. Microbial can stay or not, I'm not sure. Okay, but better bring back, okay? Okay, to make a compost, this one. This is how to make a compost. And then this is a volunteer soil doctor. They teach the farmer how to make the compost. We train them. And then LDD number two, it has an effective microbe as well to decompose fresh crop residue, fish, and golden apple snail for liquid hormone to produce red color element. Okay, it's, oh, this is really, really big market. We call it Talad Thai. Okay, this is Si Mum Muang. A lot of residue, plant residue, this one is a waste. But this waste is gold. If you making, we bring it to make the liquid fertilizer, it turn the waste into the liquid fertilizer. A lot of elements from this one. This one really good stage to produce liquid fertilizer. So that when you go back home, don't throw away residue from the plant, bring in it, put it into the liquid fertilizer, okay? Oh, it's waste, rubbish. No, this one can change critical crisis into extract liquid fertilizer by effective microorganism. This one use LDD number two. Okay, they have the I go away tomorrow. The lecturer will the next for the lecturer don't have the data to teach you, so that I go away. Okay. Oh, this is how to make this. This is it's a lot of waste. It's a paste into the field. This one is new, and then make it, to put the better a liquid fertilizer. This one. This one from the household, so that don't throw it away, making as a liquid fertilizer in your house. And then this one, we put this one, and the farmer come to take the liquid fertilizer from this one free of charge. Okay, this good to solve the problem of the bad water. Okay, we can take the liquid fertilizer and spray into the plant and get better yield. This is microbe that react against the root rot pathogen to make this one, LDD number 4, number 5, number 6. Okay. This is really good smell, pond, right? Really, really bad. Okay. So that when we put liquid fertilizer from LDD number 6, we solve the bad smell of this problem. Bad water. So that this one will solve. Okay? This one, a lot of hydrogen sulfide producing in this water. And liquid fertilizer from LDD number 6 will solve this problem. In your farm, in your fish pond, we have the problem with hydrogen sulfide. After about 28 days or 4 weeks, the water will produce hydrogen sulfide, so that every 3 weeks, you have to put liquid fertilizer into the water so that no hydrogen sulfide into the fish farm anymore. Okay, this is the advantage of this one. Number 7, this one to kill the insect, our purpose. This one, spray this one so that no need to spray insecticide. This is the purpose of number 7. Good. Longan. Our goal. Okay. This goal. Good production. Good income to the farmer. Get better money. Good production. Okay. Very good way from the patroness of our king, very kind king, to solve the problem of the land. Thank you for your attention.